Welcome everybody to Mount Van Hovenberg. We're here for the cross-country skiing. If you're watching this morning, you would have seen the women's 3x5K relay in classic and freestyle, while we're here for the men's 7.5 relay. We'll have teams of four skiers. The first two will go round in classic, and then the second two will go round in freestyle. We're on the 2.5 kilometer course, so three laps each to make up the 7.5 kilometers that each of these male athletes will take on. As we have a look at the athletes getting ready, they'll all be going off at the same time. So we look at the start list. We've got Czech Republic, Kazakhstan, United States of America, Norway, Japan. Look out for them in the final leg. Poland, Germany, Australia, with Serena Campo leading things out for them. And then we have Korea, Finland, France, with Tom Mancini as anchor, Canada, Italy, and Ukraine. So 14 teams, four skiers in each team. The air temperature has just crept above freezing. Luckily, the precipitation has stopped, so it isn't snowing or raining anymore. But it is on the warm side for cross-country skiing. It means the waxing will be quite difficult for particularly these first two legs of classic. Total climb of 87 meters, and they're off. And this men's 4x7.5 kilometer race is underway. So the main thing is to stay in the group, particularly on this first lap. As we see number 10 there, Poikkanen, just slipping back ever so slightly on that first climb. So number one, Krzysztof Saktukal of Czech Republic in the lead. All looking good so far. I don't see anyone really struggling at the beginning of this contest. Cheers for the local team, for the USA. The Americans wearing big number three. They've got Garrett Butts, who will ski this first leg. It is Nielsen that is starting to slowly increase the pace. It's not a burst of speed to get away, but it's just starting to turn the screw. The Kazakhstan Matsov just slipping slightly there. Now this is the moment where the elastic is starting to stretch. Top of this hill. And we do have a group of four that have just broken away ever so slightly. Second of the three laps about to be completed. Czech Republic, Norway, Germany, France, Ukraine, and Finland. Well, Krzysztof Saktukal was 16th in the individual 10K competition, and Fredrik Nielsen of Norway was 8th in that event. The elastic's breaking now as the final climb. Nielsen just a little bit ahead of Zatokal. And they will be going for flat out up this hill. Butts there from the University of Vermont, 22 years old, doing very well to stay in contention. So it's Norway, Czech Republic, America. The no-look tuck, just tucking his head down to gain the best aerodynamics. Just got to be a little bit careful that you don't veer off the track. And the final effort now as they go on to the start-finish straight. And great work from the American.
USA in your top three for the exchange.
And so Zatokal of the Czech Republic will be handing it off to his teammates.
So good work from Norway. They are doing the job here. Norway, Czech Republic. United States, Garrett Butts hands over. Sweet has got some speed here, and Sweet will be looking to challenge the Czech, Thomas Duvček. And a good move from France, Matteo Correa. Correa has closed the gap. Sweet slipping slightly, the kick whack's not working for him. Laura of Germany and Romanchenko of Ukraine. Well, they want to keep the gap big, but they don't want to expend too much energy. And strategy for Magnus Boyer there is just to sit up, stand up, and let's the Czech take the lead on the descent. So what was a group of three out front is now a group of four. Matteo Correa doing good work to rejoin that front group. And you can see Sweet having to come out of the tracks. The kickwack's not working for him, and that means that he's expending a lot more energy on those climbs. It's just not as an efficient technique. He doesn't get any glide. So more effort required for the American up that final climb. So this is the 10K. It's the first loop for this second leg. And still very much trying to keep the powder dry, keep the keep themselves under threshold. Sweet from the USA, doing his best to stay in contention. But we've got Boyer, Dufek, Correa, Sweet. Still fighting to stay in touch. Just not giving up. Well, it's been a great ski from both the, all three of these teams. And look at that from the French, round the outside, blasting up the final hill. And you've got to say that Korea of France has skied the fastest leg. Had some catching up to do to start off, but they're going flat out, full gas now. The full-on sprint up the hill to try and hand over with as much of a lead as possible. Dufek and Correa just distancing Boyer ever so slightly. but it will be just a few seconds that they will have over the Norwegian. Sweet. Well, how far back is he? 24 seconds back. So. Oh, that was a close one. That was almost a fall for Thomas Dufek. And a brilliant ski from the Frenchman, Mathieu Courrier. We'll hand over to Simon Chapat of France. Dufek, just get it. Oh, they've gone the wrong way. So Dufek is going the wrong way here. Dufek's completely gone the wrong way. He's going to have to go all the way back. He went on to the finish, and he's had to back himself back up. Oh, what a disaster for the Czech team.
Time and time again, Thomas Dufek going into the wrong lane.
Oh.
An opportunity now for Team USA to get back into the top three. Dufek now.
That was what you would call a schoolboy error from the team from the Czech Republic. They did all that hard work. They worked all the way through, and Thomas Dufek went the wrong way. And he thought about jumping over the barriers, but then that would have given him a penalty, so he had to ski back around. And it's France that are in the lead, and that disastrous second exchange for the Czech Republic. It's not over yet. They will get back into this race. It was only a 10-second loss, but the negative impact that will have psychologically.
Haugen dropping the pace a little bit and allowing the French skier to get into the lead. A strategic move there.
You see the Koreans a whole lap behind. So Simon Chapat of France leading, Haugen of Norway in second, Hozak 16 seconds back. Well, that was an improvement. So the skier from the Czech Republic is starting to close that gap. And there's still life left in Simon Chapat. Chapat trying to drop the Norwegian. Chapat putting a burst of speed in at the top of the hill. He's flat out sprinting to try and get a gap. Well, that's the top. Hasn't dropped Haugen though. Now the descent. Well, Simon Chapat doing a great job here, but he hasn't managed to drop Øyvind Haugen. Hozak 36 seconds back on them. If they slow up too much, then they will be caught by the Czech team. But look at the speed, look at the sprint speed of the French skier, Simon Chapat. And Mancini just setting off. As long as they tag, we can't quite see it, but they've tagged. And we have Kerkeng of Norway and Mancini of France. It's a 4-second lead for the French.
But so far in this World University Games, perhaps Kerkeng has been outperforming, so far at least, Mancini. So let's see how this matchup will develop.
Kerkeng will have to go hard to catch Mancini early on. Mancini is not going to slow down, but he's not going to go too hard too soon. Just getting into his rhythm, getting the heart rate up. There's the change for Czech Republic, 43 seconds. So at that the second exchange, they were 17 seconds back. They're now 43 seconds back. unfortunately didn't have a great result in the 10K Classic and then pulled out of the pursuit.
Without glasses, I don't think that'd be an option for you right now. You would definitely be having some visibility issues.
As the snow really starts to come down heavily here at Mount Van Hovenburg. Mancini through the 25-kilometer mark.
He is 1 second faster than he was at the previous time.
5 kilometers to go.
But what that might imply is with 2 laps left to go,
6.9 is the lead. It was 4.5. It's really nothing in it. But this is the battle for gold and silver. It's not over yet. Kerkeng has not let Mancini get away from him. Huge cheer from the French coach, and Mancini is really extending the lead now. So Mancini crossing the 27.5 kilometer split, final lap. And he has a 2.5 kilometer left to ski, and it's a 16 second deficit. And Kerkeng, well, the look on his face tells me that he is not going to be able to close that gap. Mancini is pressing the accelerator even early on in this third and final lap. As the Norwegian coaches stand there with their grey jackets with Norway on the back, it's the French that have pulled the blind up. There is the Czech skier in bronze position. And he's looking behind him because he knows that Hirose of Japan is mounting a challenge for a bronze. Mancini at 28.9 of this 30 kilometer race is well in the lead. One little hill left and Mancini will sprint. He's just going to show how much energy he has still got left in the system. And even though he has a massive lead, he's going to absolutely power it home. We might see him back off on the start-finish straight, but Mancini has done the job for France. Carefully round the final corner, and Tom Mancini will take the gold for France. And Hirose has gone up into bronze medal position as Tom Mancini takes the tricolour flag of France.
And your anchor right there, Thomas Mancini.
And well done to the French team. They are the gold medalists in this men's 4x7.5K. So Kerkeng is going to get the silver. That is of no doubt. The battle is for bronze. And I think it might go to Hirose.
Kerkeng.
The Norwegians, well, they were favourites going into this, but they didn't account for the French. And look at this from Japan. Well, gold medal in the team sprint, gold in the 10K Classic, gold in the pursuit, and Hirose Ryo What an incredible final leg from Hirose Ryo. That must be easily the fastest ski for... He's made up like well over a minute. Hirose crossing the line in bronze, 55 seconds back. A brilliant ski from the Japanese to take them the bronze medal. And the Czechs, well, they're going to look back at that mistake on the second exchange. And when Tomáš Dufek went the wrong way, that was what cost them a bronze medal. And look at the time gaps. 28 seconds in the end, 55 seconds behind for Japan. And Japan doing a great job to overtake the Czech Republic in the end. United States of America in fifth, Germany sixth, Kazakhstan seventh, and Finland in eighth place.
First place and cross-country skiing men's 4x7.5 kilometer relay classic free champions, France! Gianni Giacchino, Matteo Correa, Simon Chapat, and Tom Mancini!
A great, great performance from the French team. Started slowly on leg one, but were able to close that gap with Matteo Correa coming through. Simon Chapat and Tom Mancini really good in the final leg. France take the gold, Norway in silver, and Japan in bronze. Well, congratulations to the winners of this men's 7.5 relay classic and free competition.
Right there, Thomas Mancini.